There are many devices out there that cannot directly connect to the Watson IoT platform. Such non-IP-enabled devices communicate over other communication protocols, like Zigbee, Bluetooth or InOcean. The concept of gateways was introduced to enable these devices for the Watson IoT platform. Let's take a look at an example. In a smart home, there are various sensors installed. A gateway acts as a proxy between the devices and the Watson IoT platform. The gateway is allowed to send data on behalf of devices behind the gateway and receive commands for these devices. The gateway also allows device management actions like reboot or firmware update on the device behind the gateway. So let's have a look at how you create and connect a gateway in the Watson IoT platform. After the gateway is connected, we will see how a gateway can register devices and send data on behalf of a device. Finally, I show you how device management operation can be done. You start by logging into the IBM Bluemix platform. In the catalog of services, you find the IoT platform service. Create your own IoT service and launch the dashboard. Now, let's see the dashboard. Let's register our gateway. First, you have to create a gateway device type. Then you can register the gateway itself. As the gateway is registered, you can connect the gateway using the client ID, starting with a G, and the authentication token as a password. In the end of this video, you will find a link with sample code that you can use. When your gateway is connected, click on the gateway and a detailed view of this gateway is provided. Here you can find what sensor data the gateway is sending. A gateway can register devices behind the gateway using two modes, the manual and the automatic registration mode. In the manual mode, the gateway creates the device first using the REST API. Then it acts as a proxy for this device. In the automatic mode, the gateway does not have to first create the device, but can start to publish data on behalf of another device. If the device does not exist yet in the Watson IoT platform, the device is automatically created. The gateway publishes sensor data on a topic of the corresponding device. A gateway can also subscribe to the command topic of a specific device behind the gateway. Let's have a look which devices the gateway has created in the meantime. Here you see an outdoor temperature sensor that was added by the gateway. And the gateway sends the current temperature and humidity to the platform. In the details view of the device, you see the gateway or which the device is connected to the platform. Now let's have a look at the device management operation for a gateway. or the devices behind the gateway. In order for a device to be manageable, a management request for the specific device must be published by the gateway. A response to the manage request is then returned. Based on the payload of the manage request, device actions and firmware actions can be triggered from remote of the corresponding device. Every device management action is initiated on a platform UI or by a REST API call. Let's have a look at the device management action reboot. After initialization of a reboot request, the device management server publishes on the reboot topic of the corresponding device the request to reboot. As the gateway is subscribed to this topic, it receives the message and provides a response to the device management server. The gateway translates the reboot request to the corresponding device. After the device has rebooted, it connects to the gateway, which then sends a manage request to the device management server. This was a short demo of the gateway in the What's Now T platform. You can find further reference materials in the following links.